Let's talk about hip hop. All right? Hip hop basically is a culture. A lot of people, okay, they say, oh, it's rap, it's, you know, rap. Yeah, but rap is just one part of the whole culture of hip hop. Hip hop is a culture. It's like a way of life. The way we walk, you know, the way we talk, the way we hold the microphone, the clothes we wear, the music we listen to, everything is a part of our life. We live this, you know. When we wake up in the morning, it's a part of our life, you know. The definition of hip-hop basically is it's a culture, a way of life for a society of young people who love and cherish the elements of hip-hop. Now, when we talk about the elements of hip-hop, basically when it started, there were four elements. Rapping or MC, which is the most popular. DJing or scratching, you know, the DJ. In the beginning, I'll tell you the story, but in the beginning, the DJ was the focal point of hip-hop. He was the boss. And then along the way, the rapper became the most important thing. So you have the MC, rapper, DJ, scratcher. You have the B-boy or break dancer. They basically wear a lot of Adidas and Puma. But you know break dancing, right?
Yes.
Okay. So we call it B-boying. And then there is the fourth one is the art. Is we call it graffiti, but a lot of artists call it aerosol art because they use spray paint. We as hip hoppers, we would like to take our art into the studio and paint on canvases or spray paint on canvases in the art studio. I think that's the best way to do it. So those are the four elements. More elements have come up throughout the years, but the basic original four elements were rapping, scratching, breaking, and graffiti. So that's hip hop, that's what it is. It started in New York City, in the South Bronx and Harlem, where I'm from. And during that time, it was disco music was the big thing. You heard of disco music? Yeah. YMCA. So we're from the Bronx and South Bronx and Harlem. We like the music of like James Brown and, you know, the Motown sound.
Get up, get on.
Yeah, exactly. So this kind of music is what we grew up on. When I was a little boy, my mom played James Brown. She played, you know, the Motown, you know, Supremes and Jimmy Casta and Wilson Pickett, Jackie Wilson, all these old artists were now like lost because the disco came out. And so we kind of had a revolution to say, okay, we live in the world of disco. That's all we hear on the radio. But we love this music. We love James Brown. So there was a DJ who started to play just this music in the club. Instead of going downtown to wear suits and ties and the big disco ball and the flashy lights and all the pretty girls and everything, no, we stayed in the ghetto and listened to this one DJ play soul music in a world of disco. So it was sort of like a revolution. We were rebels. And even though, you know, we like the disco, yeah, it's cool, but this is our favorite thing. So that whole concept started with the DJ. His name was Kool Herc, and he was the father of hip hop, they say, because he started playing this music in the world of disco, and we all loved it. And the main thing about the music is it had great breaks. You know, when you hear this James Brown, he always had a funky break. 1, 2, 3, 4, hit it.
In the Bronx with the people of fresh air was one DJ who had to pass
Cause Timmy know he's down below and he's ready to play. That's right, y'all, his name is AJ. Never gets nervous when he cuts the beat. He gives top-notch service in the clutch on the street. A complete elite treat that can't be beat. Cause AJ never knew the agony of defeat. Sing!
AJ!
One, two, three, four, hit it. Stack. So you go, oh my God. You hear this and then you lose your mind. So we started, they call it breaking. Because when this music would play, we'd go crazy in dancing. So that's how the break dancing started. Because we would just go crazy and do our best moves because he played the music we love. And this whole concept started breakdancing and the people of the hip hop culture would go out just to hear this music. We didn't like disco. No disco. We were hip hop. So it was different. So this whole ideology, this whole scene came up out of the need and the revolt to what was happening on the radio and all the stuff that they were playing on the radio. So